So I've been gaming pretty much my entire life. My first console that I got for Christmas way back in the day was an Atari 2600. Fell in love with video games and have been gaming pretty much every day since. Maybe not every day, but you know what I mean. I've owned most of the consoles out there, from the Atari to the Coleco to Intellivision, up to the next generation with Genesis and NES to the Super Nintendo, Sega Master System, you name it. I've owned pretty much every piece of gaming hardware, and I still have a lot of old games. As you can see behind me, if you're watching the video, I mean, I got the Nintendo Switch here, that's new, but I got this great little Evercade thing right here, which is a portable emulation system essentially that is running old games on cartridges, which is fantastic. I have NES and Super Nintendo and N64 games, Atari 2600 games, you name it. I collect things, I love things, and I oftentimes play my old games. So anyway, that's a long preamble to basically say, when I was looking at the Steam Deck, I was very excited for many reasons, playing modern games, having a portable. I love portables, also something you can see if you look around in my background. But I thought about the Steam Deck running old games. Is Steam Deck possibly the best emulation device ever? I don't know. Let's talk about it. All right, so my big question is the Steam Deck the best emulation device that has ever existed? That is a really good question. I've been pretty much playing with emulators since they started, way back in the day with the early NES emulators, all the way up to building things on like a Raspberry Pi. I even built this little thing, which is a NES cartridge that has a Raspberry Pi built into it, the Pi Cart Zero. Got a little 3D printed header for the end of the cartridge. I love old games and old game systems, and I love replaying a lot of those games. So when I was thinking about the Steam Deck, I thought, you know what? Steam OS is Linux, and one of the main consoles, or sorry, one of the main OSs, it's not a console, although the Steam Deck people are calling it a console, but one of the main OSs for emulators is Linux. There are pretty much Linux versions of most of the major emulators that are going on, which is very, very interesting. So, there's been a bunch of articles that have popped up with emulation, running emulated games on the AMD, running them on the Steam Deck, looking at the GPU, and just really talking about Linux as an emulation OS. The Steam Deck is running Steam OS 3.0, which is Linux. So I quickly started looking around for all the different emulators that I can maybe start running when I get myself a Steam Deck in quarter one of next year, if I get one that early. And yeah, I ran into things like Hygen, which is an emulation master system. I don't even know how to say it. It's a multi-system emulator with different cores and things like that. There's the Dolphin emulator, which is for the GameCube and the Nintendo Wii. There's an emulator that runs on Linux called Dolphin, and that will for sure be playable. DuckStation, RPCS3, which is a PlayStation 3 emulator, a PlayStation emulator, PlayStation 2 emulator, anything, any system that you could think of. And I started thinking, like, I've built whole systems for emulation, like my Pi Cart Zero. It has an SD card built into it, running Raspbian. It's actually running a RetroPie as the build of Raspbian with all the emulators and stuff built in. And I started thinking of, could I design a perfect SD card for my Steam Deck, running all sorts of emulators, having all the ROMs, all this stuff? It's a very, very interesting topic for me. I think on my main RetroPie that I built back in the day, I think I had a 128 gig SD card that was filled with all sorts of things on it. So I've been thinking about doing the same thing with my Steam Deck. But then things got a little bit more interesting. So I looked on Steam, because Steam Deck obviously is running Steam. No-brainer there. Didn't even have to think very hard about that one. And I just had a quick peek on Steam to see if there's many emulators. I expected there to be lots because I know early on there was a really, really cool emulator, and it was called 3D Sen. And what that emulator does is take an old NES game and it takes the sprites and makes them into 3D objects. So when you're playing Super Mario Brothers, you're still playing Super Mario Brothers. You're playing the NES version of Super Mario Brothers, but all the blocks on the screen are 3D. And it was a really cool emulator, played around with it. And I was like, oh yeah, I have that old 3D Sen emulator that I could load on my Steam Deck. But then I started looking around and I found that there is a version of RetroArch that is on Steam right now. So you can just do a search for RetroArch, and you have to sign up for the playtest, which is just the way that they're putting it up there so anybody can have a copy of it. So you sign up for the playtest, or you apply for the playtest, you immediately get accepted. You hit download, and then it downloads a Windows, Linux, or I guess in this case, it would download a Windows version of RetroArch. If you're not familiar with RetroArch, I'm going to show some of the stuff here. It is essentially a multi-system emulator. So it has different cores. So there's Super Nintendo, NES, Atari 2600, Game Boy, Game Boy Advance, a whole bunch of different emulation cores built into it. And when you're in the menuing system, you can choose your ROMs, pick the ROM, it'll automatically pick the system. It will start that emulator and you're playing it. So, well, I'm showing here, there's some homebrew that I'm showing off for the Game Boy Advance, the NES, and the Super Nintendo. You could essentially load that up with anything that you want. RetroArch is frequently updated. If you look at the change logs, they're always adding stuff to RetroArch. So at the very minimum, you'll have a Steam version of an emulator that you can basically just load, install on your system memory if you want, and then put all your ROMs into the appropriate folders, put them on the SD card, and play them away. And then I started looking at some of the other options that are out there as well. So besides RetroArch, things like RetroPie, so it's running RetroArch, it's also running some other front ends. All those front ends have Linux versions, so I'm sure at some point down the road there is going to be a master page that's going to have links to all these emulators and ways for them to show up on your Steam Deck on the main menu. And really, this system could be the best emulation system I've ever held in my hands. There's a bunch of these devices on Amazon where you can find portable systems that look like a Game Boy Advance, or they look like a PSP or a Vita, systems like that. But they're running basically, a lot of them are running almost like Windows embedded. Some of them are running a version of Linux, and they're okay. They're pretty janky for the most part. All the ones that I've tried, there's major issues with the menuing system, with compatibility, with all that stuff. But if you're going to take that idea for a system, but do it instead on your Steam Deck, where is a device that we've learned where you can just wipe the drive and install Windows if you want. So at the very minimum, Windows emulators will work, Linux emulators will work, emulators that are built into Steam will work. But then there's also a lot of games on Steam that are retro in style, I guess. There's Capcom has some of their games there. You have the Konami, like Castlevania and Contra collections, that are basically running the old NES and Game Boy versions of those ROMs. And then there's a lot of other kind of like beat-em-ups, like retro-styled games. And I'm dreaming of the perfect Steam Deck that is loaded with all my favorites, all my favorite recent releases, like, Streets of Rage 4 and Streets of Red and all the other beat-em-ups that are out there. And it is really, really intriguing for me. And I guess even better is, since this system is using modern hardware, there are some emulators that are running newer things. There are emulators for the Switch and the Wii U and a bunch of other systems like that. So I'm thinking of the future. I can remember back in the day when the Nintendo Switch first came out, there was a version of a what was it? It was the NVIDIA Blade, I think it was. Or the NVIDIA Shield, a version of the NVIDIA Shield that was released in China that would play emulated versions of Wii titles. And that was on a Shield, which is essentially five-year-old hardware from when those games started coming out to it. This is new modern hardware with a modern GPU, really fast RAM, and a really decent CPU in the system as well. So if it ran on the Shield, it's going to run on this device with no problems. So I don't know what else to say here. I'm really, really excited for the thought of playing emulators in the future on my Steam Deck, loading out my perfect Steam Deck SD card, loaded to the gills with ROMs, modern games, old favorites, stuff that has been in my Steam library for the last, 15 years that I've never played. All that stuff on one SD card, and it's in a portable system that is just a little bit bigger than my Nintendo Switch, which to me is going to be awesome. So I don't know. What do you folks think? Are you going to be using your Steam Deck for emulation? Does emulation even rank up on your interests in gaming? Let me know. Leave us a comment below. I'm a big fan of old games, so emulation is definitely one of those things that I'm very much into. But I know that I'm not everybody. There's other people out there that maybe don't even think of emulation. One other point of the Steam Deck, or one other thought that I had rather of the Steam Deck, is there's not a lot of emulators in Steam right now. Emulators are legal as long as they don't include a copyrighted information like BIOS files or other stuff from the systems that they're emulating. So it makes me wonder if a lot of these emulators like Dolphin or Citra or DuckStation or some of the other ones, which are pretty common and in active development, are going to have Steam versions just for easy access on the Steam Deck. I could see a future where Steam gets almost consoleized a little bit, where things that would normally just appear on a console like the Nintendo Switch are all of a sudden appearing on the Steam Deck. So a bundled, perfect versions of something existing on the Steam Deck as a Steam download, instead of kind of you download whatever game you bought and then tweak all the settings. I do think that a lot of developers are going to put a lot of time into specifically curating the settings. Curating's not the word. Configuring the settings for optimal frames, so you'll get 60 frames a second or 30 frames a second, or bumping it up so that you can have a higher resolution all the time instead of an engine that is constantly dropping and going back and forth. They're going to do that probably naturally, but I could also see them doing similar things for emulators and bundling those and selling them on the Steam store for free, just like RetroArch did, where you go and say, I want to be part of this playtest. Congratulations, you're part of the playtest. You can play the games. Really looking forward to that. So anyway, that's going to about do it for me. Let me know below, what are your thoughts on emulation? Are you going to be playing emulators on your Steam Deck? We'd love to hear from you. Talk to you guys in the next one.